In this, what I would like to show you is how you can enable something called as parallel jobs. We need to enable parallel jobs, and these are the requirement when we want to run our pipelines. And it takes generally 24 to 48 hours for Microsoft to approve our parallel jobs. So first, within the organization which you have created, you create a project. So remember, this is your organization URL. This is the organization URL, which is supposed to have the suffix as your organization name. Now go to organization settings. In that, there is an option called as billing, organization settings billing. And under this billing, you see here, this is the parallel jobs option. Click on this parallel jobs. You will see right now it says zero parallel jobs for private project and zero parallel jobs for public project. Now when you have zero parallel jobs, you will not be able to run the pipelines. You will be able to create the pipeline, but you will not be able to run the pipeline. Initially, Microsoft used to give, whenever you create a new organization, one parallel job absolutely free for private project and 10 parallel jobs absolutely free for public project. But then the people misused it. They started creating these parallel jobs where there are some Microsoft hosted machines created for us. And on those machines, they started doing Bitcoin mining. So people misused the free thing which was given by Microsoft. So what they did now, they by default create the organization without any parallel jobs. And they ask us to put a request, and they would then validate our request and enable the parallel jobs. And right now they would allow you only for public private project. Unless you have a solid reason, they'll not give you a public project parallel jobs. You should be working on some open source project whose code should be already present in your repos, in Azure repos or maybe in GitHub. And then you should request parallel jobs which are for public project. But we don't need them right now. So don't worry too much about public project. We need right now parallel jobs for the private project. So what you do is go to this URL. You have to go to the URL. I'm putting the same thing in the chat also. Or search Google Azure DevOps request for parallelism. Click on that link. You are brought to this. Anything is okay. Click on this link which I shared with you. The reason I am asking you to click on that link is you can read this later. And you'll know the same reason why Microsoft has disabled direct parallel jobs. And they are asking you to click on this form. You'll end up on the same thing. It's the same thing. Azure DevOps parallelism request. If you Google this, you'll get here only. Give your name, whatever is your relevant name. Your email address. Now, your email address is supposed to be the same ID with which you have logged in into Azure DevOps for creating the organization. So that email ID you'll have to put here. Like in my case, I have used so and so. And then we are supposed to put here the organization URL. And that URL you can get it from here up to this. Copy this part and put it here. Request for only private. If you request for public, you'll have to give a proper reason why you should need public repository, and you have to give the repository, proper repository of your public project. You click here on private project and submit. I repeat once again, you should give your name. It can be anything which is relevant. Give your email ID with which you have logged in into Azure DevOps to create the organization. Exactly put the organization URL. This is your organization name. Select private, submit. Within 24 to 48 working hours, you are supposed to actually receive an email that your parallelism request has been accepted, and then you can come to DevOps and verify that everything is okay. Now, how do you check in DevOps portal that you have received the parallel jobs? You'll not get it today. You have put the request today. It will come after some time and this is going to become one. How did I come here? I go to organization settings from here. Go to billing. Go to parallel jobs. And we'll see one here. Now, suppose I'm having some paid Azure subscription. Suppose I went for pay-as-you-go subscription, or you opted for Azure Passes through which you have created the Azure subscription, or maybe you have activated your free trial Azure subscription. In those kind of cases, you should go to billing, set up billing, and you should connect your account to the subscription which is already activated. It can be Azure Pass subscription, it can be free trial subscription, or definitely it can be pay as you go subscription. I'm not going to get anything listed here because none of these are activated on my ID. Once you have connected here, this will turn to text boxes. Right now you see constant there. That will turn to text box. And in that text box, you can put a number. Maybe Microsoft hosted CI agent as one. And you don't have to do self-hosted, at least at this point of time. And click on save. But mind you, I repeat, setup billing option is going to work only for pay-as-you-go subscription. Microsoft Azure Passes. Maybe I have not tried though, but maybe it will also work for free trial subscription. See, if I set up this, it should validate. But the moment I click on this, it will start my billing. But none of these subscriptions it will allow. It will not. Because these subscriptions have some limit. And on those limits, it will not work. Your subscription should be active and there should not be any limit. Here I have removed the limit, but I don't want to. I mean, still it is not going to come because it is not a pay as you go. So the only pay as you go, and you should be ready to pay for the service in that case. The credit card to which this subscription is attached is going to get billed for that one additional hosted agent. Parallel job for that hosted agent. Now I don't want to do that because I'm not going to use this organization. I'll go back and I'll show you in some other organization. We already have billing. And I go to parallel jobs. And here you see. After enabling, you'll get this. Free tier, one parallel job, up to 1800 minutes per month. My job can run for 1800 minutes. We will not need more than 5 minutes. I mean, maybe 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes based on how many times you run the pipeline. Additional jobs can be purchased further as I showed you the procedure. So you have to set up the billing, connect it to your Azure subscription, change the number here for purchase of Azure additional jobs. So this is how, before you run your pipelines, CI pipelines and CD pipeline, both, you will need to have at least one parallel job enabled. And this is the procedure for doing that. Thank you.
Sir, one question.